How many shooters?
Two.
How many down?
One, a 15-year-old boy.
How bad?
Not good.
Can he talk?
They're not optimistic.
All right, get whatever you can. I'm almost there. Boxer.
Jerry Reavers took one in the chest 7-8 minutes ago. He wasn't conscious enough to talk.
Please tell me we have a witness.
Coming your way. Mr. Wilcox, this is my partner, Inspector Lindsay Boxer. Tell her what you saw.
All right, I come out of the club. I step off the curb. This white van blows right by me.
A white van?
Yeah, he came so close to me, he could have hit me. He pulls up, he parks. Then a different car blows past him, pulls up, parks right over there. A guy in a red hoodie jumps out, starts firing away.
The guy in the red hoodie, he was out of his car when he was firing?
Yeah, and the guy in the van starts firing back. I didn't even see the kid in the middle until he got hit. Is that boy gonna be all right?
He's alive. Did you see either of the shooters?
Yeah, the guy in the red hoodie, I got a real good look at. White guy, maybe 30.
Now, Mr. Wilcox didn't see the car across the street or the make of the van, but the van had a porthole driver's side. This man in the red sweatshirt, we'd like you to sit down with a sketch artist and describe him.
This officer here will arrange it.
Yeah, of course.
Sydney Thomas, San Francisco Register. I am a friend of Inspector Lindsay!
She's all right, officer.
Hey, what are you doing here?
I thought you were reading Eat, Pray, Love.
I thought you were watching Atonement. So here's a drive-by turn shootout. Any ideas?
Crazy wild hunch, drug dealers.
Hey, 911 just took a call. A white van with a porthole weaving down Georgia and Fourth dinged a couple of cars. The guy can barely drive. He must have been hit.
You will not even notice me in the back seat. Fine. Sheesh.
I need a 4-8 fire to roll my location, code 3.
Don't turn around or I will blow your head off. Toss the 9.
I'm not giving up my gun.
I don't want to shoot you, but if it means me getting out of here alive, I'll do it.
Barney, tell your client he'll take 5 to 10 for aggravated assault, or I'll get a jury to put him away for 20 on attempted homicide. You're a doll. Bye.
That was last night.
Last night was good looking, smart, and has great abs. I mean six pack, not just the top two. Have I mentioned single life is fabulous?
How'd you meet this one?
Saw him on the treadmill.
Woof.
Only one problem.
What, only one?
Claire's guest room is not the place for late night screams of passion.
Screams?
A friend at Mercy tells me the kid shot last night pulled through.
He's out of ICU, but he didn't see anything.
This one, on the other hand, was not so lucky. Chief medical examiner came in to look, said this is why he liked being behind a desk and had deputies like me. We might get an ID on him.
I managed a partial thumbprint, but a good one.
What? He barely has a hand.
Just enough skin left, though.
Did you send the print to Quantico?
Yes, and SFPD, like every other time I've gotten prints. I took these out of him. One of them blew his heart apart.
What kind of bullet is that?
Very she, incendiary 308.
In English, that would be?
It hit your gas tank, boom.
That's probably an answer to my partial print. I guess our John Doe here is in the system.
Is he a drug dealer? Claire.
He's not a drug dealer. His name is Steven Russo. And he's a cop.
Steven Russo, he was one of ours, undercover narcotics. And he wasn't just killed, he was burned alive. We're gonna find who did this and let them know what it means when they kill a cop. Boxer and Jacoby are lead inspectors.
Okay, here's what we know. The white van was ours, it was his undercover vehicle. What we don't know is if he was killed because he was a cop.
The message, people, is don't assume anything.
All right, Mitchell's team, you take street sources. Wheeler's team, take central records. I'm liaison to narcotics. Let's go.
Do we know what Russo was doing undercover?
Nothing yet.
Okay, why the stonewall from narcotics?
It's messy. One of the guys is down, I'd act the same way.
Boxer, Jacoby, they need you in the evidence room.
Oh, hey, Linz, look, since Kiss Me Not, Killer's been quiet for 4 months now.
Feds no longer consider you a target. Throw a party. No more FBI agents in your rearview mirror.
They don't actually believe he's done.
Maybe we caught a break here.
Don't bet on it, Tom. They never quit. I want to talk to Russo's wife.
No, narcotics hasn't notified her yet.
He was undercover. It's an ongoing operation.
Do you have any leads at all?
You know, the more I think about it, there's something I don't get. This guy in the red hood, the one that blew up Russo's van, he got the drop on me. He had an assault rifle inches from my head. He'd already killed another person. So why didn't he shoot me? You know, why let me live?
Cindy.
Cindy.
I don't know how you do it. If some guy held a gun to my head, I'd be a total mess. Unless it was him.
You're drooling.
You're not.
No. Just observing. Three coffees light.
Who's that? We don't know, but Lindsay likes him.
Grow up.
Wow, he likes you. Right now, he's doing a classic take a second look fake phone call. He'll turn this way in 5 seconds.
That's ridiculous. Okay, not totally ridiculous.
Go talk to him, and while you're at it, forget Tom.
Oh, God, that's over. Officially, it's over. And I am ready to get back out there. I'm just not a make-the-first-move kind of girl.
So, Claire said that a white van was blown up using incendiary bullets. Can I use that?
Sure.
Do we have anything on the victim? Name, age, anything?
Still working on it.
All right. Well, keep me posted. Why did we just lie to her? Why didn't we tell her the victim's a cop?
Undercover cop?
Well, I hear Tom talk to Narco again. They won't let us talk to Russo's wife.
We're still getting a stonewall from narcotics? She deserves to know her husband is dead. Let's pretend we didn't get that message and go see her anyway. I begged him to quit. Anything but undercover.
He was a dedicated cop.
He should have been dedicated to us.
Mom? Mom? You won't give me the remote.
All right.
Hey, guys. Just show me your room.
Hey, come on.
Do you know if Steve is on assignment?
They only saw him 2 or 3 nights a week. You know how it is. They have to avoid being followed.
When was the last time you saw him? Monday night. You married, Inspector?
No.
Well, a wife always knows. And I should have known even before he told me.
What do you mean?
I mean, he wanted out. And I never should have let it go back. This was yesterday.
Hey, it's me. I got a minute. I just wanted to say you're right. I'm getting out. Things are crazy out here. Really strange. It's going bad. So listen, I'm gonna make them bring me in and I'm never going out again. I love you.
Thank you.
Hey, kid.
Marty?
You could say Dad.
What are you doing here?
I would have phoned, but you don't take my calls. It's been what, 6 years?
Seven.
I didn't know you were counting.
When you got thrown off the force, I thought I made it clear I'm not interested in your life.
You crossed the line talking to the widow. I still have a few friends in the department who talk to me. Watch out, kid. People see you bending the rules and they're not happy.
Me? Bending the rules? Sorry, I don't need career advice from a dirty ex-cop.
Don't go easy on me just because I'm your old man.
Right, I forgot. It's all about you. Marty, it's my job. It's my case. It's my life. Stay away.
Sources in the Homicide Bureau, they said they couldn't ID the victim in that explosion.
That's what they said.
My sources say the body in the van was an undercover cop.
Narcotics flipped out when asked for comment.
I'll look into it.
Undercover cop shot in the line of duty. We wait too long to go with it. The Chronicle will have it first.
We're going with Scott's story.
Mr. Wilcox doing on our man in the red hood?
End your computer in 10 minutes.
Thanks.
Hey, Lindsay. The Register has a story up. Unnamed undercover cop killed. Every relative of every undercover cop within 100 miles is calling to see if their loved one died in that van.
Have we heard from narcotics yet?
Zip, nada, nothing.
Okay. Any relative that calls needs to be interviewed by an inspector, and anything interesting comes straight to us.
Lindsay, you all knew the victim was a cop, and you didn't tell me.
When an officer gets killed, people get scared.
We hadn't even notified the wife yet.
Don't you think that I would have held the story? But suddenly you don't trust me?
Cindy, we absolutely trust you.
What a funny way of showing it. Thought that we were friends. I thought that we were in this together.
If you'd like. I don't usually do this. I left my money in my wallet.
Don't even sweat it. Just pay me later.
Thank you.
Whoa. Sorry. You seem...
annoyed and frustrated.
No, I was going to say you seem to like coffee. I'm Pete. Pete Rayner.
Hi. Lindsay Boxer.
Hi. I'm fiending for a blueberry muffin for hours.
You don't look blueberry.
What do I look like?
More scone.
You know something, Lindsay Boxer? You're very pretty.
Wow. It's quite a jump from scones.
We can always go back to pastry.
No. It's... thank you. Sorry.
Well, I should get back to work.
Yeah, of course. I will, too. Okay. I'll stay. Okay.
You know, we all get frustrated and annoyed sometimes.
Sure. Okay, Lindsay. It's not your fault. You connect with him, but he doesn't ask for your phone number. I'm sure there's a logical explanation. Right.
Yep, no problem. Sutton just interviewed a relative who came in, says we should talk to her. She is on her way up. What?
Nothing.
Come on.
No, it's stupid. Okay, what would prompt you, a guy who thinks a woman is very pretty, to not ask for her phone number? Totally hypothetical.
You're right, it's stupid.
Told you.
Maybe I'm married.
No ring.
I have a girlfriend.
Walks like a single guy.
Gay.
I'd know.
This is San Francisco.
I'm positive.
Inspector Boxer? Sandy Foster, I was told to see you.
Right, yeah. Thank you for coming in. This is Inspector Jacoby.
Hi. understand you have a relative who's undercover?
Yeah, Andy McCarthy. He's in narcotics. Look, I just need to know if he's the cop that was killed.
Miss Foster, the man who was killed isn't named Andy McCarthy.
Oh, my God. Thank you. The problem is we haven't spoken today. He always calls me Wednesday mornings, so... I mean, our dad is in the hospital, so he calls for updates, and... And you're sure it wasn't him in that van?
It wasn't him.
Okay. Anyway, I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you.
Andy McCarthy, undercover narcotics, just like Russo.
Oh, my God.
Does Andy McCarthy look like the guy that blew up that van?
I don't want to know this.
Inspector Andy McCarthy killed Inspector Steve Russo.
One undercover cop killing another. Why?
I can think of a few reasons. I don't like any of them.
Lindsay, Warren, Bill Schroeder, narcotics.
I understand you think one of my inspectors has gone bad.
Well, Captain, that looks that way.
We have a witness sketch of the man that blew up Steve Russo's van. It's Andy McCarthy.
So Andy McCarthy, 10 years with the department, has started working for drug dealers and killing other cops? I don't buy it.
It's him in the sketch, and he did blow up Russo's van. What other explanation would you suggest?
There's an old expression. When you hear hoofbeats in the forest, you look for a horse, not a zebra. Steve Russo was posing as a drug dealer. It was probably another drug dealer that killed him.
I disagree, and we need to question McCarthy.
Not while he's on the street. We're done here.
Were McCarthy and Russo working a case together?
Yes.
Just the two of them?
One other officer, Henry Kraft. You want to tell me he's dirty, too?
Well, actually, sir, no, I wouldn't bet on two cops going bad at the same time.
Kraft could be in danger if McCarthy's killed one of his partners. We should be concerned about the other one. Captain, pull Kraft off the street.
I don't need advice on how to run my unit.
If Kraft dies, it's on you.
Boxer.
Stay away from McCarthy, Kraft, their families, and me. Get her in line, or I go to the chief.
Lindsay.
He's got a dirty cop in his unit, and he won't accept the truth.
You won't. If you keep this up, I'll have no choice. I'll have to take you off this case. I didn't want to say anything, but I hear your dad dropped by this morning.
Don't do this.
Come on, we were married when they got your dad. I watched you go through it. I know how difficult it was.
This isn't about my dad.
We both know what you're trying to prove.
What I think about Andy McCarthy has nothing to do with my father.
Both dirty cops. If I was your priest, I'd say that you're looking for redemption.
Well, I'm glad you're not my priest.
Hey, Lenz.
Ed, you look good.
Well, you know, I tried. Hey, but she's all yours. I got a young cop waiting to be told his life is over just because he's in a wheelchair.
Mm. Right. See you at home.
All right, bye-bye.
See you later. I have to ask you something.
Yeah?
Tom says I'm going after this dirty cop so aggressively because of my father. He's crazy, right?
Maybe. And maybe he has a point.
Maybe you're both crazy.
Fine, I'll shut up.
Claire? What's the matter?
Sorry. Just working some things out.
What, is this about Jill saying you guys are cramping her style again?
No, she hasn't mentioned that in a while. It's Ed. It's not working.
It's... Oh.
I mean, there was always a chance that the paralysis would get worse, and one of the first signs would be down there, you know. Your case last year, you know, where you helped that doctor's daughter? I tried to get an appointment with her, but there's a 6-month wait. Maybe you can pull some strings?
Sure.
Thanks.
How long has this been going on?
Almost 3 months.
And honestly, I am going out of my mind.
I will call her today.
Thank you. And I heard about your hypothetical situation.
He flirted, I flirted, and nothing.
Maybe he's shy.
I'd say he's the opposite of shy.
Maybe he's gay.
I'd know. I'm positive. I'm positive.
I'll see you after lunch. They're prepping me for my grand jury testimony on a double homicide in the Mission.
Yeah, grand jury. I just figured out how to find Henry Kraft.
You're suggesting what I think you're suggesting. The answer is no.
These three cops were making cases a long time undercover. They must have given confidential grand jury testimony.
Lynn, no.
If I can see their testimony, I can find out where they worked and where they hung out, and then I can find Henry Kraft.
Talking about sealed documents, their testimony, the district attorney's notes.
I know.
I do this. Someone finds out, the least I lose my job. I could be disbarred.
Narcotics won't give me anything. Come on, Jill, I'm telling you, this cop is in trouble.
I need something besides your hunch.
I don't have anything else. You're not gonna help me.
This isn't about you, just like it wasn't about Cindy. We're friends, but we all have jobs to do. I'd like to keep mine.
Okay. I'm gonna find Annie McCarthy, and I'm gonna find Henry Kraft. And if you don't help me, I'm gonna find a way. They said the FBI was finished keeping an eye on me. I appreciate the concern, but you're wasting the taxpayers' money.
I'm not a Fed inspector. And you should stop telling stories about Andy McCarthy being dirty.
What's your name, officer?
Look, I have been through Andy McCarthy's checking, his savings, the credit cards. He is living on his salary, Lens. Nothing here says he's on a drug dealer's payroll. Nothing. I'm buying.
He's not on a dealer's payroll. Why'd he kill a cop?
Coffee light? Mocha Suprema with extra caramel. Jacoby's hooked on sugar.
Yeah. There was a guy here yesterday.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Blueberry Muffin.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, wow. Okay, non-fat latte, double shot. He works in that office building. Next time he passes by, do you want me to mention you were asking?
Yeah.
Yeah?
No.
No?
No.
No?
Thank you.
I'll drink Jacoby's mocha. Let's walk. I gotta tell you, everyone thinks you're a little overinvested in this because of your dad.
I'm trying to save a cop's life. Okay. This has nothing to do with me or my dad.
Lindsay, we all know it's not easy being Martin Boxer's daughter. The looks, the whispers, living with it your whole career.
If I say you're right, will you give me the grand jury notes?
Anyone finds out about this, I could end up doing time, and I don't think I'd enjoy the food in prison. Read it and burn it. Before McCarthy killed Steve Russo, they worked a couple of cases together. The third cop, Henry Kraft, was part of those operations, too. This will tell you who they talk to and where they go.
Henry Kraft. Officer Henry Kraft.
Well, somebody else.
I'm Inspector Boxer. This is Inspector Jacoby. We need to talk.
I need to talk to nobody.
One of your guys, McCarthy, turned.
You heard about Steve Russo? McCarthy killed him.
Not a chance. I know McCarthy.
We think McCarthy's after you now.
I'm undercover. I'm gonna stay under until I get called in. Now, the only ones looking to get me killed are you.
We gotta take him in.
McCarthy, don't do it!
Come on, man.
Everything's gonna be copacetic. Come on, baby, put the gun down. Come on, McCarthy.
Come on, Andy. Put it down. Just put it down.
That's it.
Where's McCarthy? He's my guy, so I'll do the interview.
Captain.
Not another word. You went after him in direct defiance of my orders.
Bill, it's Boxer's case.
Step back, Tom.
Boxer is the reason that Henry Kraft is in the hospital, not in the morgue. You've been blocking us every step of the way. I get it. You got a bad cop, you want to clean your own house, but it stops here. I go to IA.
I'm watching.
Hi, Andy. Andy?
Andy, we need to talk.
Andy.
I have to go. I can't be here.
You want to tell me why you shot Henry Kraft?
You could have shot me, but you didn't. Why is that?
Man, I have to go. I cannot be here.
I can't be here!
Tell me about the watch.
Ramos gave it to me.
David Ramos. Salvadorian drug lord.
They'd do that. They'd buy you things and treat you like a friend. But you're not. But Ramos, man, he saw right through me.
Ramos made you.
He figured out I was working undercover. And then they put a gun to my head. They made me tell them everything. They told me I had to kill Russo. And Kraft.
Andy, why didn't you come in and tell us?
Because they found out where I live.
Oh, God.
You're in my home. They have my wife and my son. I didn't want to kill anyone. I had to. They have my family. They have my family.
The hostages are a woman and her 10-year-old son. There's two captors.
I want no police presence within sight of that house. These guys see any sign of police, they'll kill the hostages.
I got it, Lieutenant. No uniforms, no sector cars. My men know how to do this.
Judge Anderson issued warrants to cover entry and surveillance.
I didn't think we'd need warrants to save two people's lives, right?
Which is why you carry the gun and I see the judge. Good luck.
Hey. I got your message. What's up?
I'm sorry I didn't tell you about Russo.
It's okay. Let's put the body armor. Frankly, it's a little bulky on you.
We got two hostages and we're gonna go get them. It's your exclusive if you want to watch.
Wait, if you're doing this just because you feel guilty, I want to say awesome.
Lindsay, she signs a liability release. Get it before we leave.
Suddenly, this feels very serious.
Can we see in the house at all?
They've got every front window covered. You might be able to see something from the back.
Anything from parabolics?
Still positioning. We should have viewers inside in a minute.
Heat sensors up.
That must be two of Ramos's men.
Now, where are the hostages?
McCarthy's wife, son on the floor. It's a water heater below them.
We gotta get him out of that room. We go in when he's there, he'll kill them all.
I don't know how we do.
Got something on the horn.
One of them's making a cell call. Whoever he's talking to says McCarthy hasn't checked in. The guy in the house wants to know if it's time to shut it down. The caller thinks yes, but wants to confirm. Says he'll call back with an answer in 5 minutes.
They're gonna kill that woman and her child.
All right, we create a diversion at the front, draw the second guard into the living room, we go in.
I'll go.
No, they will make you as a cop and kill those people before you can ring the doorbell.
And they won't make you. You got cop tattooed on your forehead.
All right, all right. We need someone else. Call the bureau.
We can't get anybody here in 5 minutes.
I can do it.
Forget it.
You need someone who's not a cop. That's me. And I speak Spanish.
I said forget it.
They're civilian. It's out of the question.
Narcotics used civilian decoys in a string of busts in the Haight last year.
Those are for dime bag busts, not hostage situations.
Lieutenant, they're moving the woman and child.
You have to let me do it. Tell me how.
And then when we start to make our move, right, you'll see us coming in. The moment that you do, drop to the ground. Don't run, don't move left or right. Okay, just pancake on the ground.
Pancake. Got it.
You scared?
Terrified.
Good.
SWAT team Charlie, on the move.
SWAT team Alpha approaching from east side of house.
Decoy approaching front of the house.
SWAT team Charlie approaching west side of house.
Delta team, are you in place?
Delta team in back of the house.
Team situated on all four perimeters.
My name is Cindy. Miss Seagal down the street is my aunt. She said that you have keys to her house.
No hablo inglés.
Oh, I see, I see. Me llamo Cindy. Yo soy la sobrina de la señorita Seagal que vive en esta calle. Ella me dejó sus llaves aquí.
¿Por qué no tienes llaves? Lárgate, ¿ah?
Puede revisar. La señorita se enojaría si el gato se queda sin comer.
Escúchame.
Eduardo.
¿Cuál es el problema?
Number two on the move.
What is the problem?
I spoke to St. Mary's. Your wife and son are fine. They're gonna release him in about an hour.
Thank you. I spent 2 years trying to get someone to testify against Ramos. Now I'm gonna do it myself.
Whatever works.
Steve Russo is life. I didn't know him that well. We weren't friends. Now he's in my head. Every minute of the day. The cop I killed. Steve Russo. The cop I killed.
Two visits in 2 days. Really unpleasant record.
The
Congratulations on saving the cop's family. Proud of you, hon. Wasn't always his way, was it? I remember walking you down the aisle and sneaking you that slice of pizza at the reception.
And look how all that turned out. Goodbye, Marty.
How'd you find Henry Kraft? You pulled off a miracle and people want to know how. They don't like you for it, Lindsay. They see you cracking these impossible cases and they want to know how you do it. What have you got that no one else has?
Who's asking? Schroeder?
Not just him.
So that's why you're here? To tell me that people are pissed off because I'm a good cop?
No, I'm here to warn you not to make the same mistake I did.
I won't be taking paper bags full of 50s from Dominic Bucci if that's what you're asking.
Is that what you think I did?
That's what the court says you did.
If a case like this teaches you anything, it's that things aren't always what they appear. I'm still your father, like it or not. See you around, Lindsay.
Hey.
Hi. How much did you hear?
Didn't hear a thing.
We've been collectively considering the question of why an eligible man wouldn't ask a smart, funny, strong, beautiful woman for her phone number.
I had nothing to do with this.
And?
It's the gun.
The gun?
It scared him off.
I wasn't carrying a gun.
Oh, but he could sense the gun. Yeah, face it, Linz. Some women are always carrying their gun, even when they're not.
Sweetie, we love having you as a house guest, but we're cramping your style.
Actually, I think I'm cramping yours.
Guess our walls are pretty thin, huh? How much have you heard?
A lot. I don't know much about marriage, Claire. Except the obvious. Just consider the possibility it's always about two people, not just one.
Here. Great job today. And I shouldn't have brought up your father. It wasn't about him.
Tasted love so sweet, and all of it was lost on me. Bought and sold like property, sugar on my tongue.
Look, you think this doctor friend of Lindsay's can help?
No, I don't.
What?
You don't need a doctor, Ed. We do. Someone that we could talk to about what's been going on. With both of us.
All we are, we are. All we are, we are. Every day's a start, something beautiful.
Lindsay Boxer.
I have a question for you.
Me first. How'd you find me?
I'm a detective.
Yeah, I heard. The kid at the coffee cart.
I told him not to say anything.
Your question?
Right. My question is, why does a man have a nice conversation with a woman that he thinks is pretty and then doesn't ask for her number?
Maybe the man thought about asking for her number.
Oh. How hard did he think about asking?
He occupied his whole afternoon, including a number of calls to friends for advice. But then he remembered that he's only in town for 2 weeks.
Where are you going?
Cambodia. I build hotels. I'm there for a year.
So you think in 2 weeks I'll get attached and then you'll break my heart?
No, Lindsay, I think in 2 weeks leaving might break mine. Still, I was about to come find you. Are you a good detective?
Well, I'm better at my job than I am at this.
Well then, detective, who are those flowers for?
I don't have enough information. Kept falling over. Kept looking backward. I went to Lindsay.
You want to get something to eat?
Yeah.
Don't forget the flowers.
Okay.
Every day is a start, something beautiful.
Don't you think that I would have held the story? But suddenly you don't trust me?
Cindy, we absolutely trust you.
I have a funny way of showing it. I thought that we were friends. I thought that we were in this together.
I...
Coffee light?
I don't usually do this. I left my money in my wallet.
Don't even sweat it. Just pay me later.
Thank you.
Whoa! Sorry. You seem...
annoyed and frustrated.
Nah, I was gonna say, you seem to like coffee. I'm Pete Rayner.
Hi, Lindsay Boxer.
Hey. I've been fiending for a blueberry muffin for hours.
You don't look blueberry.
No, what do I look like?
More scone.
You know something, Lindsay Boxer? You're very pretty.
Wow. It's quite a jump from scones.
We can always go back to pastry.
No. It's... thank you. Sorry.
Well, I should get back to work.
Yeah, of course. I will, too. Okay.
Just give me...
I'll stay. Okay.
You know, we all get frustrated and annoyed sometimes.
Sure. Okay, Lindsay. It's not your fault. You connect with him, but he doesn't ask for your phone number. I'm sure there's a logical explanation. Right.
Yep, no problem. Sutton just interviewed a relative who came in, says we should talk to her. She is on her way up. What?
Nothing.
Come on.
No, it's stupid. Okay, what would prompt you, a guy who thinks a woman is very pretty, to not ask for her phone number? Totally hypothetical.
You're right, it's stupid.
Told you.
Maybe I'm married.
No ring.
I have a girlfriend.
Walks like a single guy.
Gay.
I'd know.
This is San Francisco.
I'm positive.
Inspector Boxer? Sandy Foster, I was told to see you.
Right, yeah. Thank you for coming in. This is Inspector Jacoby.
I understand you have a relative who's undercover?
Yeah, Andy McCarthy. He's in narcotics. Look, I just need to know if he's the cop that was killed.
Miss Foster. The man who was killed isn't named Andy McCarthy.
Oh, my God. Thank you. The problem is we haven't spoken today. He always calls me Wednesday mornings, so... I mean, our dad is in the hospital, so he calls for updates, and you're sure it wasn't him in that van?
It wasn't him.
Okay. Anyway, I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you.
Andy McCarthy, undercover narcotics, just like Russo.
McCarthy. Oh, my God. Does Andy McCarthy...
I got a minute. I just wanted to say you're right. I'm getting out. Things are crazy out here. Really strange. It's going bad. So listen, I'm gonna make them bring me in, and I'm never going out again. I love you.
Okay.
Hey, kid.
Marty?
You could say Dad.
What are you doing here?
I would have phoned, but you don't take my calls. It's been what, 6 years?
Seven.
I didn't know you were counting.
When you got thrown off the force, I thought I made it clear I'm not interested in your life.
You crossed the line talking to the widow. I still have a few friends in the department who talk to me. Watch out, kid. People see you bending the rules and they're not happy.
Me? Bending the rules? Sorry, I don't need career advice from a dirty ex-cop.
Don't go easy on me just because I'm your old man.
Right, I forgot. It's all about you. Marty, it's my job. It's my case. It's my life. Stay away.
Sources in the Homicide Bureau, they said they couldn't ID the victim in that explosion.
That's what they said.
My sources say the body in the van was an undercover cop.
Narcotics flipped out when asked for comment.
I'll look into it.
Undercover cop shot in line of duty. We wait too long to go with it. The Chronicle will have it first.
We're going with Scott's story.
Mr. Wilcox doing on our man in the red hood?
In your computer in 10 minutes.
Thanks.
Hey, Lynch. The Register has a story up. Unnamed undercover cop killed. Every relative of every undercover cop within 100 miles is calling to see if their loved one died in that van.
Have we heard from narcotics yet?
Zip, nada, nothing.
Okay. Any relative that calls needs to be interviewed by an inspector, and anything interesting comes straight to us.
Lindsay. You all knew the victim was a cop, and you didn't tell me.
When an officer gets killed, people get scared.
We hadn't even notified the wife yet.
Not giving up my gun.
I don't want to shoot you, but if it means me getting out of here alive, I'll do it.
Barney, tell your client he'll take 5 to 10 for aggravated assault, or I'll get a jury to put him away for 20 on attempted homicide. You're a doll. Bye.
That was last night.
Last night was good looking, smart, and has great abs. I mean six pack, not just the top two. Have I mentioned single life is fabulous?
How'd you meet this one?
Saw him on the treadmill.
Woof.
Only one problem.
What, only one?
Claire's guest room is not the place for late night screams of passion.
Screams?
A friend at Mercy tells me the kid shot last night pulled through.
He's out of ICU, but he didn't see anything.
This one, on the other hand, was not so lucky. Chief medical examiner came in to look, said this is why he liked being behind a desk and had deputies like me. We might get an ID on him. I managed a partial thumbprint, but a good one.
What? He barely has a hand.
Just enough skin left, though.
Did you send the print to Quantico?
Yes, and SFPD, like every other time I've gotten prints. I took these out of him. One of them blew his heart apart.
What kind of bullet is that?
Very she, incendiary 308.
In English, that would be?
It hit your gas tank, boom.
That's probably an answer to my partial print. I guess our John Doe here is in the system.
Is he a drug dealer? Claire.
He's not a drug dealer. His name is Steven Russo. He's a cop.
Steven Russo. He was one of ours, undercover narcotics.
And he wasn't just killed, he was burned alive. We're gonna find who did this and let them know what it means when they kill a cop. Boxer and Jacoby are lead inspectors.
Okay, here's what we know. The white van was ours, it was his undercover vehicle. What we don't know is if he was killed because he was a cop.
The message, people, is don't assume anything.
All right, Mitchell's team, you take street sources. Wheeler's team, take central records. I'm liaison to narcotics. Let's go.
Do we know what Russo was doing undercover?
Nothing yet.
Okay, why the stonewall from narcotics?
It's messy. One of the guys is down, I'd act the same way.
Boxer, Jacoby, I need you in the evidence room.
Oh, hey, Linz, look. Since Kiss Me Not, Killer's been quiet for 4 months now. Feds no longer consider you a target. Throw a party. No more FBI agents in your rearview mirror.
They don't actually believe he's done.
Maybe we caught a break here.
Don't bet on it, Tom. They never quit. I want to talk to Russo's wife.
No, narcotics hasn't notified her yet.
He was undercover. It's an ongoing operation.
Do you have any leads at all?
You know, the more I think about it, there's something I don't get. This guy in the red hood, the one that blew up Russo's van, he got the drop on me. He had an assault rifle inches from my head. He'd already killed another person. So why didn't he shoot me? You know, why let me live?
Cindy.
Cindy.
I don't know how you do it. If some guy held a gun to my head, I'd be a total mess. Unless it was him.
You're drooling.
You're not.
No. Just observing. Three coffees light.
Who's that? We don't know, but Lindsay likes him.
Grow up.
Wow, he likes you. Right now, he's doing a classic take a second look fake phone call. He'll turn this way in 5 seconds.
That's ridiculous. Okay, not totally ridiculous.
Go talk to him, and while you're at it, forget Tom.
Oh, God, that's over. Officially, it's over. And I am ready to get back out there. I'm just not a make-the-first-move kind of girl.
So, Claire said that the white van was blown up using incendiary bullets. Can I use that?
Sure.
Do we have anything on the victim? Name, age, anything?
Still working on it.
All right. Well, keep me posted. Why did we just lie to her? Why didn't we tell her the victim's a cop?
Undercover cop?
Well, I hear Tom talk to Narco again. They won't let us talk to Russo's wife.
We're still getting a stonewall from narcotics? She deserves to know her husband is dead. Let's pretend we didn't get that message and go see her anyway. I begged him to quit. Anything but undercover.
He was a dedicated cop.
He should have been dedicated to us. All right.
Hey, guys. Why don't you show me your room?
Hey, come on.
Do you know if Steve is on assignment?
I only saw him 2 or 3 nights a week. You know how it is. They have to avoid being followed.
When was the last time you saw him? Monday night. You married, Inspector?
No.
Well, a wife always knows. And I should have known even before he told me.
What do you mean?
I mean, he wanted out. And I never should have let it go back. This was yesterday.
Hey.
How many shooters?
2.
How many down?
1, a 15-year-old boy.
How bad?
Not good.
Can he talk?
They're not optimistic.
All right, get whatever you can. I'm almost there. Boxer.
Jerry Reavers took one in the chest 7-8 minutes ago. He wasn't conscious enough to talk.
Please tell me we have a witness.
Coming your way. Mr. Wilcox. My partner, Inspector Lindsay Boxer. Tell her what you saw.
All right, I come out of the club. I step off the curb. This white van blows right by me.
The white van?
Yeah, he came so close to me, he could have hit me. He pulls up, He parks. Then a different car blows past him, pulls up, parks right over there. A guy in a red hoodie jumps out, starts firing away.
The guy in the red hood, he was out of his car when he was firing?
Yeah, and the guy in the van starts firing back. I didn't even see the kid in the middle till he got hit. Is that boy gonna be all right?
He's alive. Did you see either of the shooters?
Yeah, the guy in the red hoodie, I got a real good look at. White guy, maybe 30.
Now, Mr. Wilcox didn't see the car across the street or the make of the van, but the van had a porthole driver's side. This man in the red sweatshirt, we'd like you to sit down with a sketch artist and describe him.
This officer here will arrange it.
Yeah, of course.
Cindy Thomas, San Francisco Register. I am a friend of Inspector Lindsay!
She's all right, officer.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Thought you were reading Eat, Pray, Love.
I thought you were watching Atonement. So here's a drive-by turn shootout. Any ideas?
Crazy wild hunch, drug dealers.
Hey, 911 just took a call. A white van with a porthole weaving down Georgia and forth, dinged a couple of cars. The guy can barely drive. He must have been hit.
You will not even notice me in the back seat. Fine. Sheesh.
Henry, 15. I need a 4-8 fire to roll my location. Code 3.
Don't turn around or I will blow your head off. Toss the 9.